welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for clicking on the video. This is Tolu, and if you are returning, thank you so much for always coming back. And if it's your first time, you are super duper welcome to this YouTube channel. And on this channel, I talk and vlog about Christian faith, lifestyle, motherhood, and love. And today we are going to be doing faith together by doing a devotion this morning. So our topic for today is living a faith life. Living a faith life. And if you don't know, we use Logos devotional. And if you're yet to download Logos, you can go to www.greathaven.org, go to media, click on Logos devotional. You can either view on the website or download, whatever works for you. Okay, thank you all very much. So we go today, living a faith life. I read, "For everyone born of God overcomes the world. This is the victory that has overcome the world, even our faith." 1 John 5:4. When you are faced with a daunting challenge, when things go hard and money stops coming in, or you lose your job, when the doctor gives you a bad diagnosis and everything goes wrong, always bear in mind that you have a blood-bought victory and blessing. God loves you more than you can love yourself. His arms are bigger than yours. He is a good God. Don't also forget that you are blessed, not because you are fine, but that you are fine and will be fine because you are blessed. The blessing of the Lord is in and on you. He has not promised that there won't be trials, but that you will come out of it beautifully and your waiting will be worth it all. He has not promised that there won't be storms and hard times, but that greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world, and that the victory that overcomes the world is our faith. Okay? Living a faith life does not mean that you won't have any trouble. Absolutely not. It means you have the answer when trouble comes. Faith looks not at what happens to him, but at him whom he believes. Okay? So you're not looking at the circumstances around. Instead, you're looking up to God. You're looking at God. You have a beautiful hope. You have a lively faith. What makes the whole difference is that the one with whom you have to do is with you and is not an indifferent bystander. He is Emmanuel. He has come to stay. He is for you and not against you. Here is what you have to do when you're going through challenges, when you're having struggles living a life of faith. Feed on and rest in His word and His love. Know that your battle belongs to God. It takes your case more personal and personally. Your only fight is to remain in faith. Keep feeding on God's word. Assure yourself in it. Rejoice in it. Confess it. And sooner than you expect, you will receive comfort. Peace will rise big in your heart. And things will turn around for your good. Alright? So when you're going through situations, when you're going through challenges, don't see the big challenges. Don't see the big situation. Instead, see your big God who is able to turn things around for you. All right. And make sure that no matter what happens, you're not downplaying yourself. You're not downplaying what God can do by the words of your mouth. Instead, you assure yourself constantly in the word of God concerning places that He has said that there is nothing impossible for Him to do. Just reassure yourself in that part. Continue to work in that light. Keep feeding yourself in God's word, and eventually things are going to work out for you. Okay? So I have a question here for you. For the believer, what is his assurance that he is victorious? We have a lot of answers here, but most importantly, an assurance that we are victorious as believers is that we have a blood-bought victory and blessing. The victory we have is not ours. The victory we have is His. We sang a song in church yesterday, "The Battle Is Yours" by Paul Wilbur. if you can check out that on YouTube, go ahead, play it and sing. There is a line of the song that says, "Victory is mine, cause the battle is yours." So it's very important for you to know that you are not the one fighting for yourself, because sincerely speaking, when you fight for yourself, it's to no end. Because what do you know? Why not let he that has won the victory over sin and death do this for you? Because if he has won victory over sin and death, it can mean victory over anything at all, you name it, he can win it. So our assurance is in the blood bought victory that we have and the blessing we have in Christ Jesus. If you want to know more about this blessing, you can go to Ephesians chapter 1 and read about the spiritual blessing that we have. So we're going to call it a day here today. Please make sure that as you go about the rest of the year, you live a life of faith. You live a life rest assured in the victory that you have in Jesus. You live a life where you constantly pray, constantly fellowship, constantly feed on God's word, assure yourself in it, and rejoice in it while you confess it. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you guys again tomorrow. Remember, we don't have Bible study or daily devotion on Wednesdays and Sundays. And if you're yet to subscribe at this point, please do. I not only do daily devotions, but I also post vlogs and I do other things as well. Thank you so much for watching. See you later. Bye-bye.